Okay guys, I have finished gluing the elevator. I'm just going to show you what I did. Again, I'm making sure that it was nice and level with the wings. And then I did have to add a little bit of glue by the control horn. And that's where the rod comes up, attaches to the control surface. The control horn had a little tear right where it attached to the foam. So I just put a little glue around it to beef it up. And you can see they actually have a carbon fiber rod running the length of the elevator to keep it stiff. So that has actually held up real well. The tape started to come off, so I just kind of resealed that to make sure it was nice and stiff. And that's good. The elevator is exactly where we want it now. Now we can go ahead and do the rudder. Again, this is a nice clean break, so this is about as easy as it gets. I'm going to apply some glue right where it tore out. Right on the plane here, just a little bit. Filling up these little gaps here. And then we can go ahead and set it in there. Now, again, when you're re-gluing a control surface like this or a stabilizer, we gotta now make sure that it's gonna be a perfect 90 degrees from the elevator. So if I straighten the rudder for you, that looks pretty straight. You can actually get a square edge in there if you got a tool that'll do it. If you got good eyesight though, you can get it pretty close. I'm going to eye this up as she cures and make sure that it's straight. That's about as close as it gets. You can grab something that may have a 90 built into it. My remote control here, for instance. I'm just using this little remote. It has a small 90 degree built into it, so I can kind of eye it up and see how close I am. And that looks pretty good. Now we just want to make sure that it's seated well. Sometimes you can put glue on a joint and stick it in there, and it may just be touching, and you'll find that as soon as you check it, you know, maybe it pulls out. So after it's cured, let me give this a quick shot of accelerator to help quicken that process. I'll double check it by just giving it a little tug. I did the same thing on the wing. Now that it's had a chance to set up, I'm pulling apart the wing halves, and it's nice and stiff. So you know that you had a good, strong joint and not just a we could call that, I guess, a weak joint, where it's not penetrating the whole break. Looking at my rudder, I see I do need to give it a little bend to straighten it just a bit. Not much. And now here, I'll show you the shot so you can see what I'm talking about. Hard to hold that straight for you guys, but there you can go. You can see it's leaning a little bit this way. So what I'll do is I'll actually just take it and flex it. It's just foam, so you can really manipulate it quite a bit. Flex that, and that's pretty good. I also see that I missed a small rod holder on the bottom. I'm going to put in now. Too small for you guys to see, but a small carbon fiber rod. Add a tiny little holder for it to help hold the hinge. And I neglected to put that in when I glued it. There we go. Now you can see how it all goes together. Not much to it. I mean, this plane was looking like in shambles when I first got it. And now it's almost ready for flight. I'm gonna finish up the nose piece. Again, we got a piece missing here. I'll let it all cure for another 10-15 minutes. I'll go ahead and double check all my joints, make sure everything's straight, perfect 90 degrees from each other. This plane's ready to fly. Now remember, if you're re-gluing a plane, you're adding weight. Glue adds weight. Maybe a little bit, but it does add weight. So you want to double check right before you fly that your center of gravity is on and be ready to trim it out, because you'll probably need a bit of trimming after that kind of crash. So there you have it, guys. That is how to repair your foam plane. This would apply to any plane up to large scales too. You really just got to make sure you take your time. And if reinforcing is needed, if the foam's just a little too damaged, a little bit of carbon fiber rod or carbon fiber stripping you can pick up from your local hobby shop will go a long way to reinforcing something. I've had planes for years that really are in pieces without the reinforcements in them. So there you have it. Now, if you guys have any questions, you know what to do. Just comment down below. I'll try to answer anything I can. I appreciate you watching the videos. While you're at it, check out rcnightmare.com. We're going to have a lot of special features on there, extra tutorial videos just for people who go there and subscribe separately. So we appreciate you watching. Thank you much, and we'll talk to you soon.